Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Love's Data, and in this video I'm going to show you how to get started with 1Password. Why 1Password, you ask? Well, I absolutely love it. It's saved me from many frustrating moments trying to remember my passwords and has kept my login details safe and secure. I use it every day to log into my Google accounts, so it makes accessing Google Analytics, Google AdWords, and everything else super simple and pain-free. I'm going to walk through how to set up 1Password to store your existing passwords and create new passwords. Let's get started. I've been using 1Password since 2008. I can't believe it's been 10 years. Now, the team that develops 1Password have changed the way they charge for their software. Previously, it was a one-off fee to unlock and use 1Password. Now they've changed it to a subscription, so it costs around $35 a year or around $60 for the family edition. I'm not super happy about the change, but it's still my favourite password manager. So if you're not using a password manager yet, you absolutely should. By using different passwords for each different website and service you use, you'll help keep your data more secure. 1Password allows to store all your login details and passwords and access them using a single master password. You can also store credit card details, software licenses, and other sensitive information. 1Password uses strong encryption to keep your information safe. First, you'll need to download 1Password. You can download it directly from the 1Password website. If you're on a Mac, you can download it from the App Store. You can also download 1Password for iOS and Android. I've included links to download 1Password in the description below this video. You can try 1Password for free for 30 days and then you'll need to purchase the subscription to keep using the software. Now that I've downloaded the software, it's time to open 1Password. Since I've installed it for the first time, I'm going to select Start My Trial. I downloaded it from the App Store, so I need to agree to the subscription that will start after the 30-day trial. Now I need to enter my email address. And then enter the verification code from the email I received. I enter my name, and then I need to enter a master password. This will be the single password you use to access all your login details and passwords. Choose a master password that is secure and memorable. Now click Continue. I need to re-enter my master password. You can now open 1Password using this password. 1Password allows to quickly access your passwords using your preferred browsers. Select Install Browser Extensions from the 1Password menu. This will load your default browser. I'm using Safari. Follow the instructions to install the extension. We need to authorize the browser to access 1Password. We can now see an icon in our browser that allows us to access 1Password. You can also add 1Password to all the different browsers you use, like Chrome and Firefox. Once you have installed the browser extension, you can begin navigating to websites and saving your passwords. Go to a website and enter your username and password. 1Password will now prompt you to save the password. Once the password is saved, you can automatically access it when you next visit the website. Go to the website, click the 1Password icon, enter your master password, and select the appropriate login. Your password is automatically entered. You can manually add passwords as well by entering your master password and clicking the Add button. One password can also be used to generate secure passwords. You can adjust the password generator settings as required. Now you've created a secure password. That's it. So that's how you can get started using 1Password. One of the biggest benefits, apart from helping keep your login details safe and secure, is that you can synchronize all of your passwords between your devices. This means if you're ever without your laptop, you can access your passwords with your phone or even log in online to get your passwords. I find this super useful when I'm traveling and don't want to get my laptop out. Are you using 1Password or another password manager? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. Take a moment to subscribe to my channel to receive the latest tips and tutorials. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.